Hey there, I'm Marco, aka Memory, and this is how to customize Windows 11 with StartAllBack, which is the only Windows 11 UI replacement tool that I use. First off, what is StartAllBack? Well, it's an app that replaces the Windows 11 UI and allows you to customize individual elements like the Start menu, taskbar, you can move it to the top or sides of the screen, the taskbar tray icons, and the Windows Explorer or File Explorer, and it also replaces the default Windows 11 right-click context menu. So why would you want to use StartAllBack? Well, if you wanted to bring back familiar elements from previous versions of Windows to Windows 11, if you wanted to move the taskbar or make it smaller on Windows 11, because if you didn't know, you can't do that natively in the latest versions of Windows 11. Microsoft removed the ability to do that in one of the Windows 11 updates. And if you wanted to have a better experience when searching in the Start menu, because the Windows 11 default Start menu search can be quite slow sometimes. So in this video, I'll show you how to install StartAllBack, how to configure StartAllBack, and give you my best settings, including how I set up StartAllBack on my main PC and how it compares to the standard Windows 11 UI. So if you want to make Windows 11 look and feel better than the stock experience and learn some hidden tips along the way, make sure to watch until the end. By the way, if you're looking to secure your connection, I personally use ProtonVPN. They have an actual free tier with unlimited bandwidth and no logs, which is very rare. It's perfect if you just want to browse privately or bypass basic blocks. Now, the free version auto-connects you to the fastest available server, so if you need to manually pick a specific country, like for streaming, you will need their paid plan. This video is not sponsored by them, but I do have affiliate links in the description. If you start with the free version and then decide to upgrade later, I'll earn a small commission at no extra cost to you, and it helps to support the channel. Thanks for that. Now, back to the video.
Now, before we continue, there are some things I need to get out of the way. First off, this video is not sponsored. I use StartAllBack myself, and I'm sharing it with you because I genuinely believe that you'll find value from it too. StartAllBack is not free, but it's very cheap. It's like $5 for one PC, and it offers a 100-day free trial. Now, when the trial is over, all the functionality will still work, but you'll just be nagged to purchase a license for activation. And lastly, StartAllBack is for Windows 11. If you want to have the same thing for Windows 10, then you can use StartAllBack, which is also made by the same developer. Now to get started, to install StartAllBack, there's a few methods that you can use. You can get it from the official website, which is startallback.com. You can also get it from the Microsoft Store, which is the screenshot that you can see up here. And if you want to use the command line or PowerShell, then you can also install it via Wingate with Wingate install startallback.startallback. Now for this video, I'm just going to download it from the official website. So I'll click on the download button, run the installer, and I'm going to install it for everyone. Just accept the user account control prompt, and then it will start with the installation. Now you'll see that the taskbar already changed and that the StartAllBack configuration launches automatically. Now I'm just going to close all of these windows, because if you wanted to get back to the StartAllBack configuration, all you have to do is just click on the start button, and you can see the start menu has already changed. Then click on control panel. Once you're inside a control panel, just change the view by to small or large icons. I'll just change it to large icons for now, and then you'll have this StartAllBack entry inside of the control panel. Once you click on that, you'll get back to the StartAllBack configuration. Now, once the StartAllBack configuration is launched, you'll be greeted with the welcome screen, and you'll see a bunch of different options here, like the start menu, taskbar, tray icons, explorer settings, advanced settings, and then what the app is about. But if we start with the welcome screen, you've got some pre-made themes that you can apply. So you've got Proper 11, Kinda 10, and Remastered 7. Right now, Proper 11 is selected, which features the round start menu and taskbar elements. So if I open the start menu, you'll see that it has rounded corners. Then the corner taskbar icons, which are the system tray icons. If you open those, they'll use the Windows 11 flyouts where possible. And then you've also got the new command bar in Windows Explorer, which is the command bar up here. And that mostly uses the default Windows 11 UI. Next, you've got Kinda 10, which is kinda like Windows 10, which features the square start menu and taskbar elements. So you'll see the start menu now has square corners and resembles the look of Windows 10. Then you've also got the system tray icons, which will open the Windows 10 flyouts where possible. And then you've got the ribbon UI in Windows Explorer. So in Windows Explorer, you then have the entire ribbon up here instead of the command bar that I showed you earlier. Next, you've got Remastered 7, which has the arrow start menu and taskbar style from Windows 7. And you'll also also notice that the start menu icon also changes as these theme changes. But if I open the start menu, you'll see that it has the arrow theme start menu from Windows 7 and the flyout menus in the system tray open to Windows 7 flyouts where it's possible. So you'll see that the network and sharing center is still the Windows 11 flyout, but the sound mixer, for example, is the Windows 7 flyout. So those only work where it's possible. Not all of them work. Now, for this video, I'm going to set it back to proper 11, but then we're going to go into each of these sections on the left here and change those individual settings to what we actually want our Windows 11 UI to look like. But before I do that, I want to change the Windows theme to dark theme because that's just what I prefer using. And to do that, I'm going to be using the right-click context menu. So I'm just going to minimize this window, and then you'll see if I use the right-click context menu, that's also changed and it doesn't use the default Windows 11 context menu. StartAllBack also automatically replaces the Windows 11 right-click context menu with the classic context menu that you got in earlier versions of Windows. So I'm just going to open the personalization settings here, and then I'm just going to change the colors to dark mode because that's just what I prefer using. And now we can get into each one of these individual groups here. So let's start with the start menu. First off, for the start menu and the taskbar, you can actually toggle if you want to use them. So you'll see up here, it says use enhanced classic start menu. And if I toggle that off and I open the start menu, you'll see it now uses the default Windows 11 start menu, but I've still got the StartAllBack taskbar settings applied. So if you just wanted to use StartAllBack for one specific thing, for example, moving the taskbar, which I'll show you later on in the video, you can just toggle off the enhanced classic start menu and still use the default Windows 11 start menu, but with the StartAllBack taskbar. And vice versa, if you only wanted to have the enhanced classic start menu, but you wanted to keep the Windows 11 taskbar, then you can just toggle off the taskbar settings. But to continue, I'm going to turn on the start menu just so I can show you what type of settings you have access to here. So you can change the visual style between default, which is the Windows 11 one with rounded corners, or you can use plain 8, which is the Windows 10 start menu, or you can go to the Windows 7 one, which is the Windows 7 arrow start menu. I just leave it on the default, which is the start menu with the rounded corners that suits the Windows 11 aesthetic more. Then you can also change the icon size between small, large, and medium. So if I change this to small and open the start menu, you'll see that they've all become a lot smaller now. And you can also change the icon count, how many icons you'd like to see inside of the start menu. You've got some options with regards to all programs, if you want to use large icons for that, display as a flyout menu. So you'll see by default, if you open the start menu and click on all programs, it'll show this list. But if you change it to display as a flyout menu and you open that and then all programs, it'll just show it as a flyout menu next to the all programs arrow that you see here. So as you can see, you get access to a ton of options that you can set and customize to exactly the way that you want the start menu to look for you. You can also change the items that show up on the right side of the menu. For example, these folders on the right here, these items that you can see here, you can choose to display it, to link it, or to show it as a menu, or you can even add custom folders to the right side of that menu so you can get easy access to it. Now we get to the taskbar section, and this is actually why StartAllBack is the only Windows 11 UI replacement tool that I use. It's for two reasons. The first one being I can move the taskbar to any part of the screen that I want, and I can also make it transparent. But let me walk you through this section and then we'll get to those settings as we go along. So just like I explained in the start menu section, you can toggle off the taskbar settings. You'll have to restart the Explorer shell for it to take effect, but then you'll see you have the Windows 11 taskbar back. But if I click on the start menu, I still have the start menu replacement active. Now, I obviously want the enhanced classic taskbar to be enabled, so I'll just enable it, restart the Windows Explorer process again. And now we'll get into some of these settings. So again, we've got the visual style, which is basically just choosing between default Windows 11 style, plain 8, which is more like the Windows 10 style, and then the Windows 7. And I already showed you how each one of these look when I showed you the preset themes that are available in the welcome screen. Next, you've got the icon size. So by default, it's set to medium, but you can also change this to small, large, or extra large. Now, just to show you what extra large looks like, it makes the taskbar huge. And what I like to do is I like to set it to small so that it's extra small icons and that the taskbar takes up less space on my computer. And then you can also change the icon margins, meaning how close each one of these icons are to each other. Now here you can change it between extra small, small, medium, large, and extra large. So if we put it to extra large, you'll see there's a bunch of space between each icon down here. But once again, what I like to do is change it to extra small so that it just takes up less space on the taskbar. Next, you can change the start menu icon on the taskbar. So by default, it'll apply the icon for the visual style that you have selected, but you can change it in the settings here. So you can see as I'm clicking through these icons, it's changing the start menu icon. So we've got the Windows 10 icon, we've got the Windows 7 icon, and then some custom icons that's made by StartAllBack. But I like to keep the Windows 11 icon selected for my use case. Then we've got some additional settings down here, and this is what I love about StartAllBack. So we can change the taskbar location on screen. I always put it to the top, but you can also put it to the left or to the right, or you can keep it at the bottom, whatever you want. I usually set it to the top, like I just explained. And then you've got the option to combine taskbar buttons. By default, it's set to always and hide the labels, but you've also got some other options down here. I just leave that on the default. Then you can center the task icons. And when that is checked, it basically gives you the Windows 11 style menu. I like to keep it at the left of the screen, so I'll uncheck that. You've got plumpness. And when you activate that, you have option between buffer or aura. Now you'll see if I select aura, it's almost like the taskbar separated from the top of the screen. I don't know if you can see that very well, but there is a gap between the top of the screen and the taskbar. And you can also activate segments. So the taskbar is basically hidden, but we only have the part of the taskbar where icons are present, and then the system tray icons to the right there. You can automatically hide the taskbar if you want, so that it's only shown when you actually hover your mouse over that area of the screen. And then one of my favorite settings, dynamic transparency. So you'll see when I enable this, the taskbar becomes completely transparent. And then you can even drag stuff behind the taskbar and still see a slight preview of it, although the transparency does change when you have something behind the taskbar. Now, next we get to the tray icons. Now here you can choose the flyout style. So you've got the Windows 11 flyouts, Windows 10 flyouts, or Windows 7 flyouts. And like I said, when I showed you the pre-made themes, these only apply to the flyouts where it can actually be used. So for example, the network flyout still uses the Windows 11 flyout, although I have Windows 7 flyout selected, but the sound icon is changed. Now I keep that on the Windows 11 flyouts, but you also have options to turn system icons on or off. And these are the icons that appear inside of the system tray. What I always like to do is I like to show all of the app icons by default. What that does is you'll see by default there is the chevron that you have to click to show you the additional icons that have been hidden. So I like to show all of the app icons so I can see them all without clicking the chevron or hidden menu. And then you can decide what you want to show. Now on the left here, these three icons aren't actually related to the system tray because that's the search icon that you can see at the left here. So if I click on that, I can choose whether I want to show the search box, search icon, or hide it. I usually hide it. The same with the task view icon. If you click on that, you can choose if you want to have it on or off. I switch that off. And then you've got the news and interests or the widgets. So you can choose to have it on or off, and you can also adjust the position to the left or to the right. So I'm going to switch that off because I don't use that. Now to the right here, you've got the actual system tray icons. So all of these that are selected will be shown by default if they're active. But if you wanted to hide any of these, you can do so here. For example, you can hide the action center or the notifications. If I switch that off, the notification center will now be completely hidden. Now you can also change the icon margins to extra small, for example, so that it uses even less space. And that's what I like to do. Now, if we go over to the Explorer, which is also known as the File Explorer, once again, you can choose your style. So you've got the Windows 11 command bar, Windows 10 ribbon UI, or the Windows 7 command bar. Now the Windows 7 command bar is a little bit too basic for me, so I don't really like using that, but I don't like the Windows 11 command bar that much. So I usually set this to the Windows 10 ribbon UI. And what that looks like is it gives you clear labels on each one of these icons. But you'll also see that StartAllBack uses some updated icons compared to what Windows 10 had by default. Now you can choose to have the mica effect enabled or not. You can choose whether you want the new icons, which is what I basically just explained. If I switch that off, you'll see this is the default Windows 10 icons, but I like the new icons. I think it's a nice touch. And then you have some options with regards to classic drive grouping, and that comes in play in this PC. So by default, this is what it will look like. And if you enable classic drive grouping, you'll see the drives are now grouped below each other like that. And then you can also activate the details pane at the bottom. I just have to relaunch it for it to take effect. But then you've got the details pane here at the bottom where you can see more information about the item that is selected. And you've got even more settings here, like the classic context menus. Now, I already showed you that by default, it uses the classic context menu. But if I deselect that option and then right click, you'll see that the Windows 11 style context menu is back, and you can click on show more options to get back to the classic context menu. Now, I really prefer using the classic context menu, even with the adjustments or improvements that Microsoft has made to the Windows 11 context menu. I just think the classic one is better. Then you can restore control panel applets, and you can colorize everything with the accent color. Now, what this basically means is if I open the personalization settings and we go to colors, you can see here that the accent color that I have selected is blue. And so in turn, if I right click, you'll see all of these icons are blue. If I open this PC, you'll see that all of these icons are blue, as well as these things that are highlighted are all blue. Now, if you wanted to have a different color, you can go to the Windows settings. You can choose a different color. I don't know, let's just choose yellow, for example. If I now close this and I select the option to colorize everything with the accent color, you'll now see if I right click, these icons are yellow. When I hover over one of these items, that's become yellow. The same with the File Explorer. All of these things are now yellow, basically the accent color that I selected. We'll just change it back to blue. And then lastly, I'll just show you some of the advanced settings. So you can customize your start menu coloring and the taskbar coloring. So this is for if you wanted to have custom colors on your start menu or taskbar. I'm not going to get into that in this video. You can play around with that yourself. Now at the bottom here, you can disable StartAllBack for the current user. And lastly, in the about section, you can activate the program or check for updates. And you can see that the trial is actually for 100 days. Now, another thing I'll mention is that you still have access to the hidden start menu, and that is by right-clicking on the start button. You get access to this menu here, which gives you shortcuts to some of the Windows 11 settings. So, for example, you can get to apps and features from here, and that'll take you to the installed apps. And if you wanted to uninstall StartAllBack, you just uninstall it like any other software, you'll see StartAllBack listed, and then you can uninstall it and go through with the uninstallation process. Now, at the beginning of this recording, I also mentioned that the start menu search is a lot faster using the enhanced classic start menu compared to the Windows 11 start menu. And if I just open the start menu here and do a search for something like music, you can see that it's almost instant. And what I really like is there are no search results from Bing or any online results. Now, if I compare that with the Windows 11 start menu and I type music, you can see that at least for this term, it was quite fast and it shows me the media player and the folders. But you can see that it also shows me the results from the web and the store, and then some other settings. And these are basically ads that are baked into the Windows 11 start menu. So that's why I just prefer to use the enhanced classic start menu, because it just works a lot better in my opinion, and it resembles that of earlier versions of Windows. Oh, and if you're wondering how much resources StartAllBack uses, it doesn't use any resources, as you can see from the search on the task manager here, because it just uses the files that are already available in Windows to show you the UI that you want to see based on your selections in the application. So what you can see on screen here now is basically the way that I like to set up my installation of Windows 11. I've got the taskbar at the top with very small icons. I use the enhanced classic start menu, and then I also use the Windows 10 command ribbon, but with the updated icons. And to me, this makes Windows 11 a lot more usable. And I haven't had any issues with the software, with it bugging out or crashing Windows or anything like that. I think it's a major improvement compared to the standard Windows 11 UI that you get straight out of the box. But with all of that being said, let me know what your perfect setup is for Windows 11. And don't tell me that it's Linux. And as always, I just want to give a special shout out to all of my YouTube members. Thanks so much for all your support. I really appreciate it. And if you've never seen my video on Shell, which is a Windows 11 right-click context menu replacement that you can fully customize, then you need to check out this video up here right now. So go ahead and check out that video, and I'll see you guys soon.